Greetings, YouTubers. Today I wish to start a conversation concerning women in movies and how this has changed over the course of the recent years of women taking center stage. Now, as a feminist myself, I am happy that women in the film industry are being given larger roles. Compared to the early 2000s superhero movies, women are being given a lot more agency, which is commendable. However, it's the way how some superhero movies that do it either really well or really badly that make or break it. Now, with the early 2000s, movies such as X-Men and the Fantastic Four were made to appeal to the general audience they were being targeted for at the time. What I mean by that is, these movies weren't being made for people who read comic books. They were just being made for people who wanted to see a grounded superhero movie. Unfortunately, these films produced by Fox, which were some of the more grounded superhero movies we've ever known, were a byproduct of satisfying the audience they had at the time. Women in movies during the early 2000s weren't likely to take center stage. They weren't envisioned as leaders. When you compare that to the Fantastic Four or X-Men comic books, where characters like Storm, the Invisible Woman, Jean Grey, and Rogue were made to be these empowering women figures and matriarchs of their teams, it downgrades these women characters. For example, in X-Men The Last Stand, Jean Grey's Phoenix moments were nothing more than a glorified staring contest, with Famke Janssen sitting there, crying, whining, and screaming in so much anger with no real emotion there. And when the final battle ensued, she just stood there, deadpanned, while all the action transpired. It was almost as though women in the superhero movie genre were being forced to take a back seat, while the men were made to be these patriarchal, leader-like figures. Think about what kind of message that's sent to women at the time. It is such an old-fashioned mindset. While I don't mind people who are old school, you can't just expect me to be pregnant in the kitchen cooking for the rest of my life. And that's unfortunately how the X-Men movies of the early 2000s painted Jean out to be. She was just a pretty face. It couldn't have been a more disempowering version of her character. Another example of this is Jessica Alba's Sue Storm, the Invisible Woman. Now, I'm just going to warn you all now. I love the early 2000s Fantastic Four movies. I love both of them so much because they got the core things about Sue Storm's character correct. They made her out to be this matriarchal, loving, compassionate woman who at the same time isn't afraid to speak her mind or let Reed Richards know exactly how she feels. However, while Alba was able to capture that essence of Sue's character, there was always something holding her back. The director, Tim Story, told her specifically that he was mainly concerned with her looking pretty, to the extremity that he told her to not cry on camera because he thought Alba didn't look beautiful when she showed emotion. He insisted on putting CGI tears on her face, which cheapens Alba, who is actually a really high caliber actress, in my opinion. And Alba has voiced that the Fantastic Four movies left her so discouraged that it made her walk away from acting because it cut down on her self-esteem and made her feel worthless. Now we're in a time period where people want women to be the star. People want to see strong female characters take center stage. Unfortunately, this can sometimes lead to the women coming off as a Mary Sue, but we're getting to a point where it's being done a lot better. The first Last of Us video game is a perfect example of a positive portrayal of a strong female character. It was done very well, and Ellie is endearing, and she makes you love her. However, there are also those female characters who aren't done all that well. Captain Marvel was a primary example of this. Now, I'm among those who liked it when it first came out, but the more I think about it, the more I disagree with how Carol Danvers' story was told. The character was just going through the motions, and they were trying too hard with her through bad writing choices. Unlike Wonder Woman, whose story was of a woman believing in compassion and love to fight against war, Captain Marvel's story was a forced attempt to make us sympathize with what should have been the villains of the story, the Skrulls. The Skrulls were made to be these sad refugees who were just looking for a new home while they were being oppressed. That's not consistent with their character and who they are. And Carol's story of her finding out about all her repressed memories, she just seems to get over it very quickly. Additionally, her powers proved to be inconsistent. Now, I'm saying her powers are inconsistent because Kevin Feige hyped her up to be Marvel's most powerful woman character, who could be the one to defeat Thanos. But then, you watch Avengers Endgame, and Carol just shoots a photonic blast at Thanos during the last battle, and she gets smacked around like a rag doll as Tony Stark becomes the one to sacrifice himself for the greater good. Carol wasn't the hero of Endgame. The heroes of Endgame were Black Widow and Iron Man, and now there's a talk of an A-Force movie being produced, and Carol is supposed to be the leader? She did not prove that she's a charismatic leader during Avengers Endgame, and for someone of Brie Larson's acting caliber, who's starred in emotional independent movies such as Room and Short Term 12, it's a waste of her acting talents. Now, let's compare Captain Marvel to X-Men Dark Phoenix. X-Men Dark Phoenix did everything that X-Men The Last Stand ever should have. It was a concise story. It made Jean Grey the centerpiece by focusing on her emotional turmoil as the Dark Phoenix persona takes over her mind, body, and soul. That's consistent with the comics. She's surrounded by those who love her and are willing to lay down their lives for her. Watching Cyclops blast Vuck out the window in order to save his girlfriend will forever put a smile on my face. But what makes Dark Phoenix better than Captain Marvel is that Sophie Turner was given a lot more agency. Jean's Phoenix powers were consistent throughout. The Dabari had a role that remained consistent with the comics, in which their planet was destroyed by the Phoenix, and they want to begin again. And Jean's sacrifice was her choice. She knew that it was her burden to bear, and she knew that in order to save her friends, she had to evolve into something more and become full-on Phoenix. Yet this movie got torn to shreds in favor of Captain Marvel, which felt yada 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 at best and was just going through the motions, not feeling like anything special. X-Men Dark Phoenix felt special because it hit the right emotional chords with me. It touched my soul when I first watched it, and it continues to. Captain Marvel just didn't do that. It didn't make me get choked up. It didn't make me feel anything when I walked away from it, and unlike Dark Phoenix, which left me feeling like a kid on a sugar rush. Now, say what you will, but the roles for women in superhero movies are improving. While not all of them are done remarkably well, the amount of women roles in film that are coming forth are a major step up compared to that of the early 2000s, which was focused on women being side characters. I rest my case that women roles in film are slowly getting better, and that the best is yet to come.